Right now, he's day to day. You know, after the game, of course, you know, he was pretty sore. And, you know, had a good performance, but he's pretty sore. And just still taking the same precautions that we did in this last week to make sure it gives him a little bit more healing time. I don't think we had as many days as we did the last week.
Is it a little easier to play him this week considering you got the long bye?
Is it a little easier to play Hamilton this week? To play Darian. The biggest thing is we just want to make sure week by week, taking it without the bye, just making sure that it's not going to push him back in any type of way. You know, the bye always helps just because it's always some extra time off. But at the end of the day, just want to make sure that we don't set him back.
Why was he in the game as long as he was? His last touchdown pass with 6 minutes left.
Well, there was about 6 minutes left last year, and they came back about 18, 19 points. So you didn't ask me that last year when they came back. So the whole thing is for us to win the game. He's the starting quarterback, and we win games with our starting quarterback.
Is it back to square one with his foot? Is it as bad today as it was, say, last Friday after his 2 days practice?
I think there's still soreness or whatever, and, I think he's at one of those points to where it's not going either way, you know. I can't give you the medical on it. Like I said, it's not so bad that he can't walk or anything like that. It's just precaution and starting over to make sure that we do the same process to see whether he makes it to game time.
Is tomorrow kind of the drop dead? If he doesn't practice tomorrow, he won't go? Or?
I would say no, just because, like I said, when you plan a team back-to-back, it's more so carryover from both teams. It's kind of hard to come with a brand-new game plan. So there would be some things that are similar, and you add one or two things. So at this point, I wouldn't say. I think really – it may even go down to a game-time decision.
What's Scott McHenry? What's his status?
Scott will be out. You know, I can't tell you exactly what it is. It's a shoulder injury, but he'll be out for a week or two. You know, he won't be ready to go, so we'll just have to figure out who's next up and how we'll shape the roster with that guy not being there.
Why do they say they don't like the back-to-back? Are you in that camp, back-to-back games?
It just depends. You know, there's a positive and there's a negative to it, you know. From a coaching standpoint, you know, you have back-to-backs, it's kind of hard to just scrap everything and come up with something brand new. It just depends on how many days there is apart. Sometimes it's also, like I said, an advantage. You know, if you look at like a Labor Day or a Banjo Bowl type thing, you know, you're going from one loud environment to another. So each situation is different.
Secondary, it looks like a couple guys are close to returning, considering everyone's playing well.
Yeah, they're teetering back there. They, they're starting to chump at the bit, and you know, it's one of those that once again you have an opportunity to play the same team again, and you know, there are some guys that need to get familiar with each other. Eddie Russ and Prince Miller played, so you know, I don't want to play musical chairs unless we have to.
What changes? I mean, at that point of the game, when he's in there, he's still well enough to throw blocks for Corey, et cetera, et cetera. And now he's not at practice on day one. Is it just swelling up after the game, or was there a hit that he absorbed?
No, I think it's one of those, you know, anytime you're playing a football game, there's always adrenaline and things there. But when you just look at the bigger picture is just making sure that he gets to be 100% healthy. So it's kind of like if every week or every day we can gain a little bit more health and get a percentage base there, it'd be better off for us.
How would you grade out the offensive line through the first 4 games?
Well, you know, I think they did a good job. You know, Doug's doing a good job with that group, you know. It's not just rated by sacks, but, you know, they're doing some good things. They're keeping the quarterback pretty healthy for the most part. And those guys are playing well together. You know, it's not one of those things where we hear a lot of bust or mental assignments or anything like that. So I think they're doing a good job thus far.
What lessons do you take away from last year when you shut out the Winnipeg Blue Bombers and then have to go to their place and it goes right down to the end when you take on Hamilton doing the same thing?
Well, I think it's the same thing. You know, it's always tough. You know, the nature of once you beat a person, especially when you shut them out, then, you know, it doesn't matter who it is. There's a whole different mindset. You know, not saying that team didn't come ready to play the last week, but it'll be a little bit tougher. Also, you're not in your home environment where you have your home fans, 35,000+ screaming. You'll be in a whole different environment. So you won't have that energy to vibe from. You just have to be able to play straight-up football. And also, this team we're playing has made so many changes in the last couple of days that we are playing a new team again.